So very good morning to all the students of class 9th D. We have already completed the chapter Weathering the Storm in Arzama. Fine. And in detail we have discussed. Fine. So today we are going to discuss question answers. And as I told you that I won't be giving answers today, you will be giving me the answers and then I will be explaining the answer to you. Okay. If any point will be missed. So let's start the discussion. Okay, if you want to answer, you have to switch on the video. This is my condition because I know that when you are not switching on the video and then you are raising the hand, you can read it from anywhere. Fine. So please, whatever you have learned from the chapter on the basis of that, whether you are speaking 1 point, 2 points or multiple points, I just want that you speak directly from your heart what you have learned rather than reading from some book. So what havoc has the super cyclone wrecked in the life of the people of Orissa? So havoc here means destruction. Clear? Three children raised hand. Okay. Prachi, you can speak this.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, answer this question.
The super cyclone has caused a very much large impact on the lives of people in Odisha. The heavy and continuous rain has filled the villages with darkness. Ancient trees were uprooted and crashed to the earth. There were screams all around the houses and houses were swiftly washed away. There was water everywhere and a lot of destruction. Bloated animals and human corpses were floating in every direction. All around, even huge trees had fallen down. There was the all destruction in that on the villages.
Very good. So all the points she has directly read from the book. That's good that she has taken the points from the text only. Fine. That's very good. So you can add up anything else into anything. Any point missed, anybody would like to add into it, can raise hand. So first question, almost all the points are covered. Beta, they are asking about havoc. Fine, havoc here means destruction. So super cyclone in Odisha created a lot of havoc, a lot of destruction. Firstly, we will tell that it was a devastating storm. You will tell that what sort of storm. So please note down the points. Clear? Rather than started jumping upon the destruction it caused, firstly tell that what sort of storm it was. So you note down. Devastating storm. Devastating means which created a lot of destruction. Clear? If you can see my screen. Let me wait. Yes, beta. Please note down the word. I will give the chance. Those who are raising hand, please. Firstly, please note down the keywords. So, clear, it was a devastating storm which created a lot of chaos and destruction. Clear? First line mein you will mention that. And then after that in the book it is mentioned already that it washed the houses away, it destroyed hundreds of villages, it killed thousands of people, many trees were uprooted. Clear? Underline. Dead bodies were all around, carcasses of animals and corpses of human beings could be seen floating in the water. Fine. People became homeless, many children lost their parents, many parents lost their children. Fine. Many women became widows after losing their husbands, and then this destruction continued for 36 hours. Okay. You need to tell the duration also. Clear? This destruction continued for 36 hours. Condition seemed quite grim even after the super cyclone. Clear? Situation was quite Q-U-I-T, quite grim, G-R-I-M. Grim means serious, even after the super cyclone. So, fine, in the beginning you mentioned, then you mentioned the things which happened, and then after that, you need to conclude the question also. Fine. Now we have second question. How has Prashant, a teenager, been able to help the people of his village? Yes, Titiksha, you can answer this.
On reaching his village, Prashant found deplorable condition all around him. He had leadership qualities, so he took the initiative to rehabilitate people. He made a team of young volunteers and cleaned urine, filth, vomiting, and floating carcasses. His team was fully dedicated to serve others. He pursued grief-stricken women to look after children. In this way, he became a ray of hope for all.
So all the points are covered. Well done. Fine. How has Prashant, a teenager, been able to help the people of his village? Now you will tell that firstly that Prashant was a boy with very strong determination. He was quite helpful towards others. Fine. So he decided that he would lead the people of his village who are in very deplorable condition. Deplorable condition is very poor circumstance. Clear? And then you will tell that on reaching his village, he found cures all over. Cures means disorder, fine. And being, he had good leadership qualities. So he decided to take the initiative to resettle the people over there with whatever resources he was having. So he utilized all the resources. He collected all the friends and he created one group of volunteers. Fine. And then after making a team of volunteers of all the members of the youth, he first and foremost necessity was cleanliness. Clear? So he, along with his friends, along with other group of volunteers, he cleaned the, you can say, urine, filth, vomit, floating carcasses and corpses, etc. Clear? And his team was fully dedicated to the work. So you'll mention that. And clear, they have mentioned that. Beta, unhone kya pucha aapse? How did he help the people of his village? So in this, it is a question in which so many things will be there. Firstly, he took care of the cleanliness. Then secondly, he talked to the merchant of the village to arrange to give or donate rice to them so that everybody gets the basic necessity, that is food. Fine. After that, he also, you can say, helped the village people by communicating with the helicopters who were passing by so that they started throwing packaged food. Fine. And above all, you can say, you can also mention the last one, that how he arranged that orphan children will be taken care of by the, you can say, widows or single parents of the same village, of the same community. So starting from cleanliness, then food, then shelter and relationships, and even, you know, he arranged games for, you can say, children, because they were mentally drained. And so he decided that he will help the children come out of depression, and he himself played cricket with them. And then he also engaged women in the family in some work, fine, as food for work program mentioned aapki book mein. So sare points aa sakte hain isme. Agar long question aayega to you will develop many points. If it's the short question, then in one line, one point you will mention, okay, the way we are doing in classes earlier also. Then next is third question, beta. How have the people of the community helped one another? What role do the women of Kalikud, Kalikud is the name of the village, play during these days? So this question has two parts. Yes, Divya, you can answer this, beta.
Under the leadership of Prashant, villagers helped each other by assisting each other. They worked together to collect food for themselves and helped each other in bandaging. They together cleaned the shelter. Women also played an important role. They were asked to take care of children. Women started to work in a food for work program established by an NGO.
Yes, fine. And yes, you can mute yourself. So in this question, firstly, they are asking first part, how have the people of the community helped one another? So firstly, you will mention that it was Prashant who took initiative of leading the crowd in his village when chaos were there, disorder was there. So after seeing Prashant, many volunteers came forward. Fine. And many women also joined him in this initiative. In this time of distress, people of the community, they joined their hands together to work for the noble cause. Then women started working in the food for work program. And not only this, they also started taking care of the orphans of the village. Okay, so they are saying that women of Kalikuda, it is mentioned only. So then women, they took care of both the things, food as well as orphans who were feeling secluded, who were feeling lonely because their parents were no more. So they played the role of mothers as well as food providers. Fine. So women played the role of food providers as well as mothers to the orphaned children. Clear? So people came forward in the need of the hour. Jinki turn ho chuki hai, they won't get another chance, please. I want maximum student participation. Fourth question is, why do Prashant and other volunteers resist the plan to set up institutions for orphans and widows? What alternatives do they consider? So firstly, you remember when government announced that those who became orphan during this super cyclone will be sent to the widows in different communities so that both can heal together. Fine. So Prashant and other volunteers, they resisted this plan of the government to set up the institutions for orphan and widows. The reason behind this was, yes, Kathy, you can answer this better.
Prashant and other volunteers resisted the plan as they felt that it would not be proper to set up a separate institution for orphans and widows. The group of volunteers was opinion that in these institutions, children would not be able to get love and widow would suffer from stigma and loneliness and isolation. The group decided to make their own community. New families were made and childless widow took care of orphan.
You can mute yourself. So fine, answer is very much clear. Firstly, we will mention in two lines the plan made by the government. Fine. So the government's plan was to send orphan children to the homes of widows, varied different widows in different communities so that both can heal together, because this super cyclone destructed many communities and many villages in Odisha state. But Prashant and other volunteers, they resisted this plan of government because they felt that it will not do the purpose, it will not solve the purpose. Because already these children were going through mental depression, they were going through tough stage of their lives. And if they will send to some different communities altogether, a big change in their lives can lead to more destruction in their lives. They will not be able to settle down themselves over there. So it is better. The idea is good, according to Prashant and his volunteers, that to settle the orphaned along with in the families of widows and single parents, but the idea should be imposed in the same community. not in different communities. Because when children will be sent outside their communities, they will not feel comfortable. They will be in trauma. They will feel bad. And they will not be able to lead a happy life over there. Clear? So this is the reason. Alternatives ka meaning yehi hai ki what other choice they suggested. They suggested that they should be sent to the widows in their own community only. Yehi alternative unhone suggest kiya tha. Clear? New families should be found in the same community only, not in some other communities. Do you think, fifth question, let me show you on the screen. Yes, this question I'm going to talk about now. Do you think Prashant is a good leader? Do you think young people can get together to help people during natural calamities? Yes, raise your hands. Any other child, beta? Same children are raising hands. I want more and more students. Rishikesh, Lisa, Jasleen, Jia. Nobody is raising hand. What happened? Class mein to sabhi aap answer karte ho, see. Please take your online classes seriously. Don't consider it to be in a casual way. So I will discuss this question. Do you think Prashant is a good leader? Undoubtedly. Yes, Jia has raised hand. Okay, Jia, you can better speak.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, Prashant is a great leader. He has all the qualities of a leader. He has a special quality of taking initiatives. Even though he himself was grief-stricken, he decided to lead the people of his village. He organized a group of youths and elders to help others in the tough time. He faces adverse circumstances courageously. He is a source of energy for others and has great motivational power. Yes, I think young people can get together to help people during natural calamities. Young people are full of energy and strength.
Very good. You can mute yourself here. So, undoubtedly, you cannot say no in this question. There is no choice even. So you will write that undoubtedly Prashant is a good leader as he has all the qualities a leader should possess. Fine? And, you know, firstly, he himself was grief-stricken. He himself was in trauma. The way he, you can say, faced that storm for 2 days at his friend's house. But even then, he came out tougher out of this situation and decided to help others. This is the first and foremost quality of a leader, that he should be courageous. So being courageous and brave, he decided to help others. He faced adverse circumstances many times, but even then he did not stop. He organized meals for the hungry. He provided shelter to the needy. He organized games and sports for the children. Fine. He engaged women in the work. So all, you can say he became a multitasker here. Fine. He became multitasker by doing many things at the same time. This is also one of the good quality being a leader. Clear? And yes, the second part they are asking that, do you think young people can get together to help people during natural calamities? Yes, because young people are full of energy. Young people have a lot of creative ideas. Fine. Young people are full of passion to do something for the sake of others. And if they are given responsibility to handle something, they will definitely come out brighter with their ideas. They will definitely help others. So yes, according to us, young people can help in the, you can say, need of the hour of natural calamities, because they are very spirited young people. Okay. Now, we have done. Yes, beta, we have done these textual questions already. Fine. We have done these five questions, and please now note down some additional questions which are not written here, but we will also do in your notebook. Fine. Five questions, these you will write that we have discussed along with value points. Sixth question, please write down write the character sketch of Prashant. Write the character sketch. Write the character sketch of Prashant. So when beta we write a character sketch, fine, we will tell a lot of, we'll be using a lot of adjectives, means the points which will be highlighting the qualities of that boy. So see, there are many qualities associated with Prashant. First of all, he is brave and courageous, fine. Just note down these points. He is brave, fine. He is a good leader also. Then if I miss any point, if you remember, you can type in the chat box, okay? Now I will not be unmuting because only 5-6 minutes are there. I will discuss the 3-4 questions and we will be done with this chapter. Tomorrow we will start another chapter, okay? So a good leader, he was brave, but he was soft at heart or emotional. Soft at heart, or you can say emotional, fine? Yes, beta. You need not write complete lines, Titiksha, in the chat box. You just write points because you need to develop these points in the answer then. Then, good organizer, you know, anybody cannot, it's not everybody's cup of tea to organize events and things for others. He settled everything in a nice way. He was a very good organizer. He was daring. Daring means the person who can take risks, fine? So he was brave is something else, daring is something else, okay? So then we can also write selfless, means he thought about others first, not about himself. So he had selfless attitude. At last, we'll say a true hero. So he proved himself to be a true leader, a true hero. Clear? Yes, savior. Jia, well done. He is a savior in the need of the R. Okay? So many points, but when you write the character sketch, you will highlight these words in the character sketch. Jahan jahan pe word use karoge. And you have to give the textual evidence of these points also. Please note down, fine? I already discussed what is the textual evidence. Means when you are mentioning that Prashant is quite brave and courageous boy, as in the chapter, he took the, you can say, decided to walk over, and he decided to cover the distance of 18 kilometers. Even the water was clogged everywhere. So that is very brave decision. So aapko textual evidence dena hai ki what sentence proves that in the chapter that he's brave. Then a good leader. Yes, inspiration for others. Yes, Riyanshika, very good. Riyanshika is saying he's inspiration for others. He inspired many of other volunteers to come forward. Usi ko dekke saamne aaye log. That if he's doing this for us, we should also go further. Then a good leader, soft at heart. Which point tells us that he was emotional and soft at heart? Remember when he saw the destruction of the cyclone and he started crying and he thought that I have lost my family members, right? So that textual evidence you can write here. Then selfless, like he never thought about his own needs. He was crying for family. That is the point. Then daring. So all the points you will mention in the character sketch along with textual evidence. Clear? Now write down narrate the storm in Ersema. Narrate the storm, S-T-O-R-M. narrate the destruction caused by storm, narrate the storm, narrate those, mention the destruction caused during those 3 days. Anything can come in any way. The basic thing is we need to mention, we need to discuss the whole scenario when storm started and what happened and who died, how much destruction was caused. Fine. So everything we will mention in this. Narrate the storm in Ersama, E-R-S-A-M-A. Fine. So firstly, you'll mention that the storm was quite destructive. It was quite furious. Winds were against the houses, very high speed. Velocity of the wind is mentioned in the book. Mention that. Fine. Winds were blowing very fast. Fine. The trees got uprooted and darkness spread all around as if it is nighttime. It was a devastating scene. Fine. It swept away many houses, many roofs were blown away with the strong winds. Destroyed hundreds of villages, thousands of people lost their lives, fine, and corpses and carcasses could be seen floating, fine, and people became homeless, many children became orphans, many parents were not able to find their kids, all chaos all around, fine. So this is the destruction, or this is the storm which occurred in Ersama, in the state of Odisha. Clear? And the storm not only destructed lives and houses, it also destroyed the mental, you can say, emotions of, it also affected them emotionally and mentally. Clear? So this is what you will discuss in this. And then we have last question, beta, the talk about page number 43 of your book. Look at this page number 43. This question I'm talking about. Okay, ye bhi aapko karna hai after that. So they are saying, talk about the preparedness of the community for a natural disaster. You can talk about evacuation plans. Hints, aapko ye hints hain, jo on bracket mein hai na. So their question is this only, talk about the preparedness of the community for a natural disaster. Means a community ko kitna ready rehna chahiye for a natural disaster. Any natural disaster, what can be done? So you will talk about, you can say that firstly, you will say that we are part and parcel of our community. The way we have duties towards our families, similarly, we have duties towards our community also. Clear? Natural calamities may occur any time to anyone's state, fine, or area. So many natural disasters have been occurred in the past also. Occurrence of such calamities is not in our hands, but yes, preparedness is in our hands only. Responsibility lies in our hands only. So precautions should be taken timely so that the effect of such calamities can be reduced. ठीक है, क्या क्या करना चाहिए? We should have evacuation plans. आपने कभी देखा है, आप जो buses होती हैं, they have always a small window, evacuation windows are there. Hospitals में emergency, they have you know, installed to out that set out the fire. They have you know, planted over there cylinders, you can see over there, fine. So they are the part and parcel of this precautionary measures only. Emergency windows are there. Emergency exits are there in theaters also, you might have seen. So what is that? That is the part and parcel of these natural calamity, or anything can happen. A fire, you can say fire may break out at any time. Anything can happen. So evacuation plans must be made. Fine. Rehabilitation process. If destruction is caused, after that, what to do next? Rehabilitation process should be there. Permanent safe shelters should be made by the government. Some warning systems should be there. You might have seen in many of the societies and foreign countries, if smoke is there in the house, na, then there is an alarm. Jaise abhi aapke school ka alarm chal raha hai, but that is the end of the period. Actually, bell ho gayi hai. But let me finish this. So wahan pe, when smoke is there, alarms start. You can say automatically. The sensors lage hote hain, they sense it. So you can say sensor alarms should be implanted by the government or by the houses or the people, you can say responsible persons, fine. Then warning systems, jisko keh deti hai. Then relief efforts, relief funds should be there, and they are there only by government. Jab bhi koi natural calamity hoti hai, that's why government announces fund for the others, fine. Then people's organizations, many NGOs, non-government organizations should be made. And then by following these points only, we can save ourselves and others and our community at large. Okay, beta? So please do these question answers. And this is the end of your period. Have a nice day.